Hello guys, in this very quick video, I'm going to show you how you can release the memory of your PC when you are loading external audio clips into your FL Studio project. So I'm going to jump straight into the point, and if you look at my screen here, you're going to see that I have three audio tracks loaded here. And they're actually full tracks. Now, I'm assuming that in your project, you're not going to load full tracks, but then probably you're going to be loading samples or external contents from packages or anything. And this can be in WAV formats. Now, WAV is usually heavier than MP3. So as you keep expanding your project and then you add more files, you're gonna see that your memory usage is going to rocket, you know. Just check here, I have 693 megabytes. So this number refers to the memory usage right now by FL Studio. This is quite a lot. I have 8 gig of RAM, but then if you take into consideration the fact that I have many programs running at the same time and stuff, I prefer to keep this at a minimum. So there's an easy trick right now that I'm going to show you. To save about 200 megabytes of memory right now. All you have to do when you see this number going up is click on your audio clips right here. So I'm going to click on this first one. And then if you check here, you have many options, but then the one you need to look at right now is below contents. So you have this option, keep on disk. Now what keep on disk does is it's going to tell FL Studio to load the track directly from the hard disk and not try and play it within FL Studio, like import the whole audio file or something. So I'm going to check this, and now you see that immediately this number has turned to 639. So look at the difference here. When I uncheck this, this is 693 megabytes. When I check it, it's 639. So I'm going to do this for the other audio clips. Again, I click on this and then I check keep on disk. It's now 584 megabytes. And then this is the heaviest file that I've just loaded. So I'm going to check keep on disk again. And then now we are at 467 megabytes. So that's like over 230 megabytes, I think, something like that, that we've saved, which is really not bad. So now, you can use this extra memory space to further optimize your project by adding other stuff. All right, so this is what this video is about, basically. I'm going to be releasing more tricks, more tutorials on how to improve your audio quality and avoid underruns. So if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel, like this video, share it, and make sure you drop any questions or any comments that you have in the comment section. I'll try and get back to you as quick as I can. I'll see you next time, guys.